Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It's me, Saba Sayed, and I'm here with the topic of rest and motion and the types of motion. It's the first lecture of chapter number 2 of Punjab textbook board, which is used by FPISC. The content of chapter number 2 is rest and motion, types of motion, which is translatory, rotatory and vibratory, terms associated with motion, position, distance and displacement, speed and velocity, acceleration, scalars and vectors, graphical analysis of motion in which we study distance time graph and speed time graph, equations of motion and motion due to gravity. Today we will study rest and motion. Rest. A body is said to be at rest if it does not change its position with respect to its surrounding. Here you can see a man is laying down on a ground and it's not changing its position with respect to its surrounding. Motion. A body is said to be in motion if it changes its position with respect to its surrounding. Here in this picture you can see a ball is changing its position with respect to its surrounding. Example. For example, a passenger sitting in a moving bus is at rest because he/she is not changing his position with respect to other passengers or objects in the bus. But to an observer outside the bus, the passengers and the object inside the bus are in motion. Types of motion. Different objects move differently. Some objects move along straight lines, some move in curved path, and some move in some other way. There are three types of motion: translatory motion, in which we study linear, random and circular; rotatory motion; and vibratory motion, to and fro motion. Translatory motion. In translational motion, a body moves along a line without any rotation. The line may be straight or curved. The object moves along a curved path without rotation. This is the translational motion of the object. Also, rider moves in the Ferris wheel are also in translational motion. Their motion is in circle without rotation. Translatory motion. Translatory motion can be divided into linear motion, circular motion, and random motion. Linear motion. Straight line motion of a body is known as its linear motion. Aeroplane flying straight in air and objects flying vertically downhill are also examples of linear motion. Circular motion. The motion of an object in a circular path is known as circular motion. A toy train moving on a circular track, a bicycle or car moving along a circular track possess circular motion. Motion of earth around the sun and motion of moon around the earth is also the example of circular motion. Random motion. The disordered or irregular motion of an object is called random motion. Thus, motion of the insect and birds is random motion. The motion of dust or smoke particles in air is also random motion. The Brownian motion of a gas or liquid molecule along a zigzag path is also an example of random motion. Rotatory motion. The spinning motion of a body about its axis is called its rotatory motion. The top spinning about its axis passing through it, and thus it possesses rotatory motion. An axis is a line around which a body rotates. In circular motion, the points about which a body goes round is outside the body. In rotatory motion, the line around which a body moves about is passing through the body itself. Here, the main difference between rotatory motion and circular motion is that in rotatory motion, body moves around an axis. In circular motion, the axis is away from outside the body, which is moving. And in rotatory motion, the axis is inside the body, which is rotating. Here you can see a top is spinning and it has an axis which is present in the body, which is present in the top. The motion of a wheel about its axis and are that of a steering wheel are the examples of rotatory motion. The motion of earth around the sun is circular motion and not the spinning motion. However, the motion of earth about its geographic axis that causes day and night is rotatory motion. Here you can see the earth is moving on its earth is spinning, which is the example of rotatory motion. And the moving of motion of earth around the sun is circular motion, vibratory motion. Move and flow motion of a body about its mean position is known as vibratory motion. A baby in a cradle moving to and fro motion of the hammer of a ringing electric bell and the motion of string of a star are some examples of vibratory motion. Scalars and vectors. In physics, we come across various quantities such as mass, length, volume, density, speed, and force, etc. We divide them into as follows: scalars and vectors. Scalars. A scalar quantity is described completely by its magnitude only. A physical quantity which can be completely described by its magnitude is called a scalar. The magnitude of a quantity means its numerical value, which are an appropriate unit such as 2.5 kg, 40 second, 1.8 meter, etc. Example of scalars are mass, length, time, speed, volume, work, and energy. All these are the scalars. In picture, you can see that some examples of scalars are given, which are have only the quantity and the unit and their unit. They have no direction present in scalars quantities. Vectors. A vector quantity is described completely by magnitude and direction. Example of vectors are velocity, displacement, force, momentum, torque, etc. It would be meaningless to describe vector without direction. For example, distance of a place from reference point is insufficient to locate that place. The direction of that place from the reference point is also necessary to locate it. For example, there is a house in this picture and a tree is located on the right side of the 3 meter right side of that or to the east of that house, and another tree or a cycle is placed 4 meter north of a house. Consider a table. Two forces F1 and F2 are acting on it. Does it make any difference if the two forces are in opposite direction, differ from each other? Here in this case, you can see there are two types of forces acting on a table. If both forces are acting in same direction, if both forces are acting in opposite direction, both these have same effect? No, they don't have same effect. When we applying both forces in the same direction, then the table move in that direction, and when we apply both forces in opposite direction, then table will not move and will stick up in that place. Similarly, they differ due to the direction of the forces acting on the table. Thus, the description of a force would be incomplete if direction is not given. Similarly, when we say we are walking on the rate of 3 km per hour towards north, then we are talking about a vector. Representation of a vector. To differentiate a vector from a scalar quantity, we generally use bold letters to represent vector quantities, or a bar or arrow over their series. Here in this picture, you can see we have represented four letters, bars or arrowheads on the letters. Graphically, a vector can be represented by a line segment with an arrowhead, and the line AB with arrowhead at P represents a vector V. The length of the line AB gives the magnitude of the vector V, and the selected scale while the direction of the line from A to B gives the direction. That's all for today's lecture. Thanks a lot. Thanks for watching.